Hello, Vinyl Community. This is a contest response for Bill at the Vinylverse. So, if you're not familiar with Bill at the Vinylverse, he is probably one of the most soft-spoken guys in the vinyl community. He's only been doing videos for about a year now, and I've been watching him probably for a little over 6 months. So, if you're not familiar with Bill, here you go. So the theme of Bill's contest was relatively simple. What he wanted us to do was to pick 4 years of significance to us and pick a piece of music associated with that year and maybe talk a little bit why that year is significant to you. So this has been kind of fun just to see where everybody's landing. A common theme is that everybody's picking their birth year, but I don't want to do that. So I'm going to pick recent history within the last 20 years, and what I'm going to feature is predominantly electronic music, different veins of it. So if electronic music is not your bag, feel free to hop out now, no offense. But the first year that I'm going to pick is 1999, and why is that year significant to me? That is the year that I first reported to work at the Johnson Space Center. So 20 years now. And one of the albums that I was listening to in 1999 was Nightmares on Wax, Car Boot Soul. And if it wasn't for the VC, I would not know what a car boot is. So thank goodness for the VC, because those guys in the UK kind of talking about record hunting, explaining what a car boot is, and I never knew what it was. So what is Car Boot Soul? If you're not familiar with Nightmares on Wax, it's breakbeat, trip hop. He's a turntablist DJ. He preceded DJ Shadow by a few years. So if you like DJ Shadow, you may want to try Nightmares on Wax. This is one of his finest albums, and it's a nice eclectic mix of stuff. It's all I don't want to say it's completely instrumental, because there's some songs on here where there is some singing, but very relaxing. And really, one of the tracks that really defines this album is a song called Les Nuits, which is French for the night, I want to say, which is one of the samples I want to play for you here. And I'll probably give you a couple more samples just so you can get a good feel for this album. So here you go. So the next significant year in my life I'd have to pick is 2003. 2003 just happens to be the year that I got married, and I've been happily married since that time. And the album that I have to pick from 2003 is The Everlasting Blink, by one of my favorite groups of all time, which is the band Bent, which is really a duo of sorts. Now, not many people know about them. Would a lot of people be turned on to them? I don't know. I just happen to really, really like their music. And one of the things that I look for in any group is diversity. So, you know, I don't want to hear the same song, the same, you know, power chords over and over again. I want, you know, the artist to change it up. And these guys are really a good example of changing things up because, you know, there's a elements of a country song, there's elements of a soul song. It's very diverse. It is electronic. I would say this is more down tempo with a lot of interesting samples along the way. Yeah, nice printed inner sleeves on this one. And for me, you know, top 10 artists, these guys are always going to be there because they just have so much meaning to me. They probably aren't for everyone, but I would like to sample a couple of tracks off of this for you guys so you get a feel for what it's like. Here you go. So the next year I got to pick is 2007. Why is that year significant to me? Well, my work has taken me all over the globe, so to speak. And in 2007, going into 2008, I had the good fortune of living in Munich, Germany for a year, and it was just a fantastic time. I love Germany. I would happily live there permanently if I could. What was I doing there? Well, I was in with the control center folks for the Columbus Control Center. And what is Columbus? Columbus is the European module that is attached to the space station like I'm showing you here. So I had the good fortune of getting embedded with their team and getting them ramped up to begin their operations. And I stayed with that team for over a year, helping them and integrating them with Mission Control Houston. So just a fantastic time for me. The album that I picked for that year was Soundboy Rock by Groove Armada. And this is just a wonderful album. Again, I'm looking for diversity. This was actually issued on vinyl for the first time this year, and it's a music on vinyl release. It's colored records, so one is yellow, one is pink. You'll see when I play the sound samples for you what it's like. They are electronic, of course, a little more on the EDM vein, but their soul, there is sometimes trip hop. One of the songs that I did enjoy the most was a song called Paris, which features the soul singer Candy Staten. And it's just wonderful because there's a nice piano accompaniment with strings, and you know, it has some electronic stylings in the background, but it's so soulful. And then it, you know, it transitions into some nice party music a little bit, and it's just fantastic. Again, diverse album. Is it a perfect album? No, there's a couple of tracks I could do without, but it's a solid, solid album by Groove Armada. And all these that I'm showing, it's not a perfect 10, but they're all very solid albums. So here's a couple of samples from this one. So the last year that I got to pick is 2011. And why is that year significant? Well, it happens to be the year that my daughter was born. And another one of my favorite bands of all time is a Dutch band called Crack and Smack. This is probably their finest album, which is Electric Hustle. Again, with these, I'm looking for diversity. And this has a nice mix of soul, has a nice mix of trip hop, some nice samples in this one. very relaxing at times because they have some very nice instrumental pieces. So sometimes it's EDM, you know, other times it's trip hop. It's just a nice eclectic mix of stuff, and I think it's their finest album by far. I can't recommend them enough. At least their first three albums are really, really solid. Again, not perfect by any means, but, you know, really, really up there. Probably a 9 out of 10, 8 out of 10, in my opinion. So here's a couple samplings from this one. Sunday morning, get my face on. We look in the mirror with disgrace. Well, I got to leave this place. So Bill, there you have it. There's my input to your contest. And just like I told Hannah in my previous contest entry, you don't even have to put me in. I'm just happy to do a video for you and promote your channel. So thank you very much for this opportunity. Hopefully I'll get it in before the contest ends. Now that I'm back at work and I had to reshoot this video, because I did do an earlier take, but my camera wouldn't come into focus. But anyway, I'm hoping everything will gel together and I can do it before the deadline. For all of you who are watching me and you've hung out this far, thank you very much, and I'll catch you next time. When I was 17, it was a very good year. Unless you were Dr. Love, then it was 15, Frank.